Hello, a very good morning to all. Today let us take one simple example on mechanical translational system. So we know that there are two types of system. One is mechanical translational system and another one is mechanical rotational system. Mechanical translational system are modeled by three components. One is mass, friction, what we call it as a damper, and third one is the spring. So whereas mechanical rotational systems are modeled by three components. One is the inertia, and second one is the damper, third one is the torsional spring. So in this question, the mechanical system is given. So this is what we are seeing. So this is mechanical translational system is given, and the question is to find its respective mechanical network. It's the first question. And second one, so when you get the mechanical equivalent network, second one is to find the force current analogous network. So means this mechanical network is being converted into an electrical network. Electrical network, particularly force current network. Okay, so this is the question. So here in this, when we look at the question, the minimum number of displacement must be equal to the number of masses present in the mechanical system. So here the number of masses are M1 and M2. The number of displacement will be equal to number of masses in the system. So the displacement on either side of the spring or a damper must be different. So keeping these two points in mind, so we will mark two displacements. So one is x1 or here, so one is x1 and second one is x2 against masses m1 and m2. Okay, so based on these two displacement, we will draw the equivalent mechanical network. Okay, so if you find any difficulty in drawing the equivalent mechanical network, so let us draw the free body diagram for both the masses. So free body diagram in the sense, the number of forces are acting on each masses. Let us draw free body diagram for mass M1. Okay, so this is mass M1. Okay, the one is the applied force. Okay, consider this is F of t, force is been represented as F of t, and you can see here the one force is acting due to this spring. This is, I will call it as a K1 into X1. Okay, the force due to spring is directly proportional to the linear displacement, and you can see here this force is also acting. So these two elements are completely related to the displacement X1. So force due to spring element is nothing but B1 into X1 dot. X1 dot is nothing but the velocity. So we know that X1 dot equals to, it is V, that is equals to dx1 by dt. Okay. So similarly, there is one more force acting on mass M1, that is force due to spring K2. That is, I will draw here. So this spring is acting on both the masses. If I consider the mass, the force due to spring with respect to mass M1. So I will write K2 of X1 minus X2. Okay. So these many number of forces are acting on mass M1. So let us draw the free body diagram for mass M2. This is mass M2. So one force is K2. There is only one force acting on the mass M2, that is K2. So that is with respect to mass M2, I will write it as X2 minus X1. Okay, so when we know the free body diagram, let us draw the equivalent mechanical network. So we know that there are two displacement, one is x1 and x2. So those two displacement will be represented as a node x1 and x2. Okay. Okay, so now, so we have to identify number of elements which are coming under the displacement x1. So there will be m1, so k1, B1 and force F of t. So means there are three elements will come under the displacement X1. So one is mass M1. So the elements which are come under the displacement X1 will be get connected in parallel under the node X1 of t. You can see here. So another element is K1, which are completely related to displacement X1. K1 and force is applied to mass MO. So that has to be shown here. This is F of T. Now we have to identify the number of elements will come under the displacement x2. There is only one element, that is m2. Remember, always the mass will come under any one of the displacement. So now this spring element k2 is acting on both the masses, so means this will come under the displacement x1 and x2. So this is the equivalent mechanical network. Okay, so if you get the equivalent mechanical network, then it is very easy to write the equations corresponding to the equivalent mechanical network. So we'll write the equations here, just you can go through this. One second. So as there are two displacement in the electrical network, so there will be two equations. So let us write the equations related to node x1 of t. So at x1 of t, you can see the electrical network, the mechanical network. So at node x1 of t, so three elements are connected in parallel. The force due to mass is given as m1. We'll write force displacement form. So m1 d square x1 of t by dt square. So plus force due to friction. Sorry. This is a friction element. One second. Okay, fine. This is friction. So it is B1, I think. That's right, B1. Okay. The force due to friction or force due to damper is given by B1 dx1 of t by dt. We know that rate of change of displacement is the velocity, and k1 into x1, and force due to spring k2. So it's also written as k2 x1 minus x2. That is equals to force F of t. Yeah, force is applied to mass m1. Okay, so now let us convert this equation into an force velocity equation. Velocity equation. So wherever you find dx1 by dt, just replace it by v1. So m1, it will be dv1 of t by dt plus b1 into v1 of t. So plus k1, if we express x1 in terms of velocity, so it will be integration of 0 to t. So v1 of t into dt. Similarly for k2, so k2 integration of 0 to t, it's v1 minus v2 into dt equals to applied force f of t. Okay, so this is about node x1 of t. So let us write the equations for node x2 of t. At node x2 of t. Okay, look at the mechanical network. So at node x2 of t, so it will be m2, force due to mass is m2, d square x2 of t by dt square, because the displacement is x2, plus and force due to spring, so it is k2 x2 minus x1 equals to 0, because there is no applied force to mass m. Okay, this is force displacement form. So let us write this, convert this equation into force velocity form. It is m2 dv2 of t by dt plus k2 integration of 0 to t, it's v2 minus v1 into dt equals to 0. So we got two equations, mechanical equations. Let us give the numbers to this equation. This is equation number 2 and this is equation number 1. Okay, so we know that v1 is nothing but it is dx1 by dt, and v2 is nothing but it is dx2 by dt. So just I replaced these two variables as v1 and v2. Okay, right. So now the second question is from this mechanical network. So what we have to find is we have to convert this mechanical network into an equivalent electrical network. So we'll see that part now. Okay. Concentrate on equation number 1 and 2. So to convert equivalent mechanical network to an electrical network, so we have to replace these variables by electrical variables. Okay. One minute. Right. So to convert the force to current network, so force is equivalent to an current. So replace force by current, f of t by I of t, and velocity v of t by, so voltage e of t, and m by capacitor, and friction b by reciprocal of resistance, and k by spring k by reciprocal of inductance. Okay, so if you replace these two variables, replace these variables in terms of electrical network, then electrical equation will be right. So we'll convert first equation. It is f of t equals to right here. 1 minute. F of t equals to, it is m1 dv1 of dE1 of t. So velocity is replaced by, sorry, f of t is replaced by current I of t. So I of t equals to, it is c1, m is replaced by c, c1 dE1 of t by dt plus k is replaced by 1 by l. So 1 by L1 integration of 0 to t E1 of t into dt plus friction is replaced by R, 1 by R, it is E1 by R1 plus K is replaced by 1 by L2. So 1 by L2 integration of 0 to t, it is E1 minus E2 into dt. This is equation number 3. Right. Next, applying for node 2, convert this into an electrical equation, that is C2 dE2 of t by dt plus 1 by L2 integration of 0 to t with respect to node 2, it is E2 minus E1 into dt equals to 0. Okay, this is equation number 4. So just what I did is I replaced these variables, mechanical variables, with the electrical variables. Equation 1, equation 1 and 2 are replaced by these parameters. Just that's it. So now you can see here, equation number 3 and 4 are nothing but KCL equation. So earlier we used to write the equations from the KCL network. Then here we need to convert KCL equation into an electrical network. So for that, so you have to identify the number of voltage drops in the network. So here we have one voltage drop E1 and E2. In the second node we have V2. And you have to identify the number of elements which are having this voltage E1 of t. So this is C1 and 1 by L1, 1 by R1. So means these elements will be get connected in parallel. So these voltage drops E1 of t and E2 of t. Okay, so under E1 of t, so we have L1, C1 and R1, R1, C1, L1, and under E2 of t we have C2. Between these two we have L2. That's it. Correct is applied to